Here we are, another episode of Full Turn Kid Zone at Home. I said it right. Yes, I did. Woo! It only took 24 episodes to do it, too. All right, so what's the first thing we do here at Kid Zone? We pray. That's right. So I want everyone to bow your heads, fold your hands, close your eyes, and no peeking. Even the camera guys. All right. Dear Heavenly Father, we just thank you and praise you for this day. We thank you for another opportunity we have to minister the gospel in such a unique way. I ask God that you would open our hearts and our minds to receive from you today for what you have for us. For Lord, we give you all praise and glory in Jesus' name. And everybody said, amen. There we go. Yes. All right. Well, we're starting a new series today, and I'm so excited about this series. It's a series that everyone's had to deal with from time to time, and we're going to be talking about fear, and not just how we get fear, but how we can conquer fear. So we're going to be doing that here throughout the next probably 4 or 5 episodes through October, and we'll find out some really fun stuff about what we can do to eliminate fear and some of the different fears there are. There's so many different fears. And we'll deal with that in a little bit. But first of all, we've got announcements. And so I want to introduce to you our one, our only, our resident farmer, Leroy.
Hey, Pastor Ken, I'm coming.
Here he comes, Leroy. He must be finishing up the chores.
I almost tripped.
Oh, looks like you've been raking. Look at all the leaves you got up there.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, all right.
Pastor Ken.
Yes. Yes, sir.
I got a lot of fear going on in my life right now.
Got a lot of fear going on in your life right
now.
Yes, sir. Oh, yeah?
You know it's getting kind of cold outside?
Yeah, it's starting to cool down.
Yep. And so I'm afraid that our milk cows are going to dry up.
Milk cows dry up because of the cold weather. Ew,
yep.
That would be.
I'm scared the cold weather's going to wreck our crops.
Wreck your crop. Well, you're going to have to get them in pretty soon then.
Yeah. I know, and I'm
afraid that might not happen.
I'm scared that the animals ain't gonna have enough food for the winter.
Oh, yeah, that's a lot of fear.
That's a lot of fear.
Yeah. Okay. Well, we can deal with that.
So I don't know if I can or not. Oh, you know what I'm especially afraid of?
What are you especially afraid of?
I'm afraid the wind's gonna blow the outhouse over.
Oh, that would be bad. That would be really bad.
Yeah, especially if I'm in it.
Yeah, that'd be stinky.
Ooh. So, Pastor Ken, what should I do? I'm scared of all kinds of stuff.
Yeah, well, we're going to be dealing with these fears, Leroy. And I'm hoping that by the time we're done with our series, that you won't be afraid anymore.
Well, I sure hope so.
Yeah, I
Sounds
do too.
Good to me.
Yeah, so we've got some announcements, though, Leroy. I know you're here to help me out with some of the announcements. Go ahead and give us the first one.
The first thing that comes to mind is... the kids should share this video on Facebook with their friends.
Yeah, that's right. Make sure and share the video with your friends, with family. I mean, get it out there and share it. That's a good way to get the gospel out there. And I know it will help other people as well. So make sure and share it. But make sure and ask your parents first before you do.
Yeah, get your permission.
Get permission. Yeah, that's exactly right.
Hey, another thing I can think of.
Well, that's another thing you can think of.
We're having 11 a.m. service at Full Turn Church on Sunday morning.
That's a mouthful.
That was a mouthful.
Yeah, Full Turn Church on Sunday, 11 a.m. Did you say p.m.?
I think I said a.m.
Oh, I thought I heard p.m.
I might have said p.m.
Yeah, don't come in p.m. because there won't be anybody here.
Nobody be here.
But 11 a.m. on Sunday mornings, we have Kids Zone Live in our Kids Zone massive, massive auditorium.
Oh, yeah.
So you guys need to come out. We do all sorts of fun stuff there. We get a chance to do some games, and we have contests. In fact, we got a new contest coming up this week. That you guys need to be a part of. You need to come and check it out. It has to do with a pumpkin.
Yeah, I don't know nothing about that. I wasn't in on that one.
Yeah, so you got to come and check it out.
But you know what else is going on?
Mr. Leroy?
We're giving away tickets.
We're giving away tickets?
Yeah, for drawings, for candy and prizes. So if you bring your Bible, just for being here.
Yeah.
Bringing an offering.
Bringing
a visitor.
Bring a visitor. Oh, that's a good idea.
Yeah.
Yeah, we had a couple empty chairs last week. We need to fill those chairs. So we need you guys to invite your friends and stuff to bring them in. And I know they're going to have a great time, too.
Hey, so. Pastor Ken.
What?
I like that T-shirt you got on.
Well, thank you. Thank you. Yes.
That's nice. Can I get one? Yeah.
Yes, you can. We're going to take another order here pretty soon. And these are $13 a piece. These are awesome T-shirts. and I like them a lot. And we'll have to get you one there, Mr. Leroy. And I don't know, your bibs are going to kind of cover it up, though.
Well,
cover the logo up.
You know, it's the thought that counts.
So, I know.
Hey, Pastor
Ken,
you got $13 I can borrow?
$13 you can borrow? Yeah, I think we can work something out. You help us out a lot. So.
All right, well, I'm going to go back and I'm going to try to listen all about the fear and see if I can conquer it.
All right, yes. You got a lot of fears that need to be conquered. We'll work on those.
I'm checking on the cows, too.
Yeah,
okay.
See you later,
Pastor Ken.
All right, check on those cows.
Bye.
There he goes. Don't forget the chickens and the eggs and all that kind of stuff. Okay, wow. Outhouse going down. Boy, that would be not a good thing, I'm telling you. So now we have the need to know. And the need to know, you need to know. And I've got somebody that's going to help me out with the need to know right now. So, come on down. Oh! Whoa! You keep your distance. Oh, my goodness. Yeah, let's, who's under that mask anyway?
It's me. It's Justin Keith.
Okay,
I see that.
I take that off, man. You're scaring me.
I'm spooking you out a little bit.
Yeah, you're spooking me out.
Your
hair
turned
white. What's that?
Your hair turned white, Justin.
Yeah, my hair turned white. Yeah, you scared me so much, my hair turned white.
Here, let me,
Here we go. At least I got hair. All right.
That's okay. All right.
So.
Yes.
Mr. What's that? I'm sorry?
Just call me Dead Man Walking. That's what my friends
walking.
Call me.
Oh, my goodness. That's a terrible name.
Well, it comes from the fact that I try to live as dead to myself and alive to Christ.
Oh, that's good.
See,
that's good.
It wasn't my name. It was a nickname given to me by people that didn't like me walking by saying, you need Jesus. You need, just keep walking, dead man. So it stuck.
Okay. Well, give us the need to know today.
What is our need to know? Perfect love drives out all fear?
Yes, absolutely.
I didn't mean to say it as a question. Perfect love drives out all fear.
That's exactly right. That's exactly right. And that is a pretty fearful mask there you had on.
Well,
that had me scared a little bit too.
Well, it's like the fear that we have in life.
Yeah.
If we have lots of fears, we can take off the mask of fear.
Yep.
And put on the mask of love and mask of Jesus.
Yes.
And then we look like Jesus, we look like love, we don't look like skin.
So we can get rid of fear.
We can get rid of fear.
That is very
with
good.
With perfect love.
Not just any
kind of love, not like smoochy. It's the perfect love that comes from inside your heart.
That's a little scary too.
It is.
All right, well, thank you.
Oh, you're very welcome.
Thank you so much for giving us the need to know today.
You're very welcome.
Let's say it one more time.
Okay, perfect love drives out all fear.
That's right. Drives out all fear.
Yes.
Perfect love. God's perfect love drives out all fear.
Not smoochy.
Not smoochy.
Okay.
All right. Thank you very much.
I'm going to see if I can turn this off.
I don't know. That's.
It doesn't turn out. There's no buttons.
Oh.
I'll see. I'll take it over here.
All right. There he goes. He's taking it over there. Now we have a memory verse. We have a new memory verse this week, and it has to deal with fear. And I'm going to have Mr. Matt. I'm going to put him on the spot right now. Mr. Matt, come on down and help me out with a verse. There you go.
Well, you really are putting me on the spot, huh?
I am putting you on the spot. Is that on?
See the little green light?
Okay, there's a green light.
Little green light.
Well, I want to make sure you're on so that everybody can hear you out there.
Do you not think I know what I'm doing?
I know what you're doing.
Oh, I know what it is. He's just making sure that I'm all set because he put me on the spot.
Yeah.
He's making sure I got what I need.
That's right.
Yeah, there we go.
That's right. Yeah, I'm just testing.
So what am I here for again?
You're doing the memory verse.
Oh, the memory verse. Yes. That's right, the memory verse.
It's found in 2 Timothy.
2 Timothy, I think it's 1:7, right?
What? Yes. Wait. You goofed up.
How did I goof up?
You said 1:7. You forgot
something.
Yeah,
2 Timothy 1:7.
What did he forget? Forgot the dot, dot.
Yeah.
2 Timothy 1:7.
Okay.
That's right.
You have fun with that, Pastor Ken.
For God has not given us a what?
A spirit of fear.
That's right.
But power.
Yes.
Love.
Yeah.
And a sound mind.
That's
you know what's really cool? Another translation that I read one time.
What's that?
It was self-discipline instead of sound mind.
Oh, that's good. Yeah. That's good. That's
that
really good.
A different translation. Yeah, that I read
so
one time that.
We need to be self-disciplined. That's, yeah. That does.
That's
mean
how that
for
comes
a
from
mind.
A sound mind.
Yeah, absolutely. So. That's very good.
Cool.
So good, good man. For God has given us.
Not
has
given
not
us.
Give,
this.
Not. Ooh, I almost said that.
God
wrong.
Has given us a spirit of faith and love, not fear.
That's absolutely right. Thank you.
But power, love
and sound mind.
That's right.
Right. Cool. Well, thank you, Mr. Matt.
You're welcome.
Where's the font again?
2 Timothy 1:7.
Ah!
Bye.
He did it again! 1.7. I tell you, it's so hard to get good help these days. Oh, man. This is my favorite time again, and I love this time. It's time to praise and worship. And I hope that you guys are ready, because this is a great song, because it talks about we serve a mighty, mighty God. So let's all sing it together right now. Here we go. What a mighty God we serve. Oh, I love that song. That's such an awesome song. And even that robot, you know, leading it. That was really cool. So our question for you today is, how does fear begin? How does fear begin? Well, we're going to define fear. You know, a lot of times we don't always know what fear means. We know what can happen when we have it. But what does it mean? It just means an unpleasant, often strong emotion caused by what? Anticipation or awareness of danger, real or imagined. So, I mean, if fear can be real, but a lot of times fear is imagined. We make it way bigger than it needs to be because we dwell on it and we think about it. And so we want to make sure that we don't deal with that type of thing and we don't allow our mind to make it bigger than it really is. Because fear can really take over and grip you and be like a vice grip and just go, that's crazy. And you don't want that. So, but I'm going to ask Mr. Matt come up again. Mr. Matt, he's coming up right now and he's going to help me. We've got some phobias that we're dealing with. I'm putting you to work, Mr. Matt.
Well, you know, for saying how hard it is to get good help, you sure are bringing me up here a lot.
That's right. Well, you know, I got to train you. We got to work on training, yeah.
Oh, so my training comes free to you then, huh?
Yeah, kind of.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, cool. Yeah. Cool. Just making sure we're clear on that.
We have, you know, there's hundreds of different. Now, fear in the scientific form is called a phobia.
Phobia, yes.
And there's hundreds of different phobias.
Probably thousands at this
point. Oh, there's a lot. There's a lot of things that people are scared of. I mean, it's just incredible. And yeah. We're going to just be touching on a few in the next few weeks.
Okay.
But I think the first one we want to do, you know, people have a fear of sleeping.
I love sleeping.
Yeah.
How could you have a fear of sleep?
I don't know. Maybe they've had bad dreams and stuff, and they have a fear
that
way.
Well, then it sounds like they need to hear the memory verse then.
Somnophobia is what it's called.
They need the memory verse. If they're afraid of sleep, they need a memory verse.
Yes, they need our memory verse.
Yeah, because the sound mind, that's how you sleep good.
Yeah, that was found where? 2 Timothy what?
1:7.
Seven. Okay. Oh, my goodness.
However you want to do
it. All right. The other one is I can't even say it. Omniphobia.
Omphalophobia?
Yeah. It's fear of your belly button. Do you know there's actually a phobia that says you're afraid of your... There's people afraid of their belly button. Don't look! I saw you lifting your shirt to look at your belly button.
And don't try to stick anything in it
either.
Oh,
no. Yeah, don't be picking out any belly lint or anything.
No. That's not good.
And we have nomophobia.
Nomophobia. Does that mean no more fear? Nomophobia?
No, this one's a pretty recent one.
Recent, okay.
Because it says it means the fear of being without cell phone service.
Oh my goodness, that's like three generations right
that's
there.
That's like
all
coming
up
into
one.
This building right now.
Yeah.
I mean, it's like, oh, I don't have cell phone service.
Can you imagine how much like the last two generations would just self-destruct if cell phone service just went away? They wouldn't know what to do.
Yeah, they'd have to go back to the rotary dial phone. I know you guys are going, what is that?
So the moral of this is, kids, spend some time off the devices.
Yeah, don't go play. Yeah, go outside and play. Enjoy life.
You watch the video on your device and then go play.
Yeah.
Make sure you watch the video and then go play.
Now, the last one we're going to be talking about today is aquaphobia. Aqua. What does aqua mean?
Not fear of water.
Fear of water. Unbelievable. I love water slides.
So people are afraid of the thing that keeps them alive.
Yeah, and keeps them clean.
Yeah.
Can you imagine somebody having a fear of water and you're just like...
Is that why we got so many people in this world that just don't take a shower? Because they're afraid of the water?
Afraid of water. I think that's it.
I got one for you.
What's that?
Ornithophobia.
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 What is ornithophobia? What?
That thing. Yeah. It's a fear of birds.
Fear of birds?
Birds, yes.
Wow. You must be running all over the place. I'm fear of birds, you know... dropping things on my head. We're getting way off track here. You know, we're talking about aquaphobia. Well, and today our Bible lesson talks a little bit about that, about water.
About water?
Yeah, yeah. Okay. It talks about Jesus calming the storm.
Oh, I know that one.
Yes, yes.
I've heard that one before.
And so I want to thank you, Mr. Matt, for helping me with the phobia thing. And I hope you don't get any of those. Those wouldn't be good anyway.
Nah, I think we're good. That belly button one's a little weird, but I think we'll be okay.
Oh, there's some other weird ones coming up for the next week.
Oh, boy, I can't wait.
Yeah, it'll be good.
Sounds good.
Yeah, all right. Thank you, sir.
Bye.
All right. Well, we're talking about Jesus calming the storm. Now, this story takes place when Jesus was ministering to hundreds of people, and then he got on the boat with his disciples, and he said, cast off, and we're going to go across the sea to the other side. And it was night. It was getting to be late at night, and they were sailing across, and well, you know, I'm not going to go any farther into this. Let's take a look at the story of Jesus calming the sea, and we'll come back right after that.
This story is taken from the Bible in Mark chapter 4, verses 35 through 41. Throughout the beginning of Mark's gospel, we see Jesus teaching and healing a lot, especially around the Sea of Galilee. Many times when he taught, he used parables, which are short stories, to teach important lessons. Large crowds would gather to hear these stories and see miracles happen. Sometimes the crowds would become so big, he would have to climb into a boat just to get back far enough so he could speak to them all. The boat would kind of be like a stage, so everyone could see and hear him. One night, when Jesus was done teaching from the boat, he said to his friends, the disciples, "Let's go over to the other side of the sea." So they left the crowd on the shore, got into a few boats, and traveled across. While they were sailing, Jesus went into the back of his boat and fell asleep. Sometime later, a very strong wind came. It quickly got to be so strong that huge waves were coming up over the sides. Water began splashing all over and started to fill the boat. The disciples began to worry that maybe they were going to sink and drown. They were pretty scared. So they came over to the side of the boat where Jesus was still sleeping, and they woke him up. They cried, "Teacher, don't you care if we drown?" Jesus stood up, looked around, and then spoke out in a loud voice to the strong wind and the wild waves. He simply told the wind and water, "Be quiet," and "Be still." All of a sudden, the wind stopped and the water became still. Everything became calm immediately. It was amazing. Jesus turned to his disciples and said to them, "Why are you so afraid? Do you still not have faith?" Well, now the disciples were amazed by what they had seen Jesus do. They asked each other, "Just who is this Jesus? Even the winds and the waves listen to him and obey."
Wow, what did you think? Can you imagine trying to sleep in a boat with the storm hitting this boat, rocking this boat back and forth, and rain coming down in this boat? And I'm sure it wasn't warm rain. I'm sure it was pretty cold. And water splashing over the top. The disciples are trying to bail the boat out, and they were getting pretty scared. I mean, if you're out in the middle of the sea, they didn't have life jackets back then. So the boat went down. Well, you know, that's a long swim to get back to shore. And a lot of times these guys probably didn't make it. And so they were pretty scared. And so they go back. What did they do? They went back to Jesus and they woke Jesus up. Well, we know the rest of the story, right? Jesus got up and he spoke to the wind and the wave and the storm and everything calmed down. And then he looked at his disciples and said, "Why do you fear? What's up with that? You've been with me now for all this time. You have the same power and authority to speak to the storm as I did." But they didn't realize that. And so that's what happens when you don't have the faith to believe. Because if you don't have God's faith and God's strength in you, you can't battle the fears that the enemy throws your way. The Bible says the enemy comes like a roaring lion seeking whom he may devour. And so I'm going to have Miss Kim come up right now. Miss Kim, now, thank you, Miss Kim, for bringing that water. Now, Miss Kim, you can sit that down if you want. You don't have to hold it. That's pretty heavy. Now, in this bucket, there's water. And, you know, we have, you know, aquaphobia. People are afraid of water. But, you know, there's people who, Miss Kim, that don't know how to swim.
Yes.
And they're afraid of jumping into the deep end of a pool. Because why? Because they would sink. Because they don't know how to keep themselves up. And so, but I can understand, you know, there's a lot different fear when you're in the middle of the sea and the boat is sloshing and you're probably, it's probably 100 feet deep below you.
Yes, absolutely.
And so if you jump out of a boat, that's a lot deeper than this bucket of water right here.
Yeah, I'd say it's a little bit deeper.
Yeah, I would say so. So, yeah. I mean, if you got this bucket of water, you know, I wouldn't be afraid to step into it. But I'd hate to get my shoes all wet and stuff. And it would take too long to take my shoe off and my sock off and get my foot in there. But I would not be afraid to step in this bucket of water. Why? Because it's not what? It's not deep.
It's not over your head.
It's not over my head. So that it doesn't really scare me. Now, I'll tell you what, if I was on a ship in the ocean and that ship started to sink, I think I'd be a little worried. I'd be a little concerned. And so, but we know we have a God.
Yes.
That will help take care of those fears.
Yes.
And you know what do you have in a ship? You have a what?
Lifeboats.
That's right. So you know that you've got an ability. You have the chance to make it when you've got a lifeboat that you can get into.
Yes.
And you won't sink with the ship. So, but you know what's amazing is that with all of this and realizing that. We do, you know, we could have fear, but we don't have fear because God is on our side. We could have fear because the water is deep, you know what I mean? But when we have God on our side, God is like that lifeboat.
Yes.
He's like that life preserver. You know, like the disciples, they were afraid. They were scared because they thought they were going to drown. But see, Jesus was in the boat with them. Jesus, when you got Jesus in your boat, when you got Jesus in your life, it doesn't matter what fear you face. Jesus can take that fear away. You know, you've got the authority. When you have Jesus inside of you, you have the authority to speak to the storms in your life.
So that's how come he could sleep through the storm. Because the Bible says he was asleep.
Yeah, he was asleep. He didn't worry. He wasn't worried about it. You know, a storm didn't wake him up. He had no fear of it.
Unless he's like Pastor Ken. Once he's asleep, he's out.
Yeah, you know, I sleep pretty hard.
But snores pretty loud, too.
Oh, thanks. Thanks a lot. Anyway, back to our story.
Okay.
Yes, we need to have God in our lives. And when we have God in our lives, he can help get rid of the fear. But we have the authority with Jesus Christ in our heart to get rid of that fear. But the only way you can do that is you got to have who in your heart?
Jesus.
Jesus, that's right. So let's everyone bow our heads and fold our hands and close our eyes right now. Dear Heavenly Father, I just thank you and praise you for your love and your goodness. I thank you that you said that all we have to do is ask you to come into our heart. Just invite you in. So Lord, if there's any kids out there right now that don't know you as their Lord and Savior, Lord, that they would invite you into their heart right now by just repeating this prayer after me. Say, Dear Jesus.
Dear Jesus.
Please come into my heart.
Please come into my heart.
Forgive me of my sins.
Forgive me of my sins.
I thank you, Lord.
I thank you, Lord.
That you now live in me.
That you now live in me.
And that I can conquer fear.
That I can conquer fear.
Because of who you are.
Because of who you are.
I love you, Jesus.
I love you, Jesus.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Now we have the authority to conquer fear.
Yes.
Because we have Jesus on the inside of us.
Right.
So we can speak to that fear and say, go away. And it has to go. It has to go.
Now you might have to do it more than once.
Yes, it'll come. It'll try to come back. Fear is a sneaky thing.
Especially this time of year when you see all the spiders skeletons and things like that. It's just, that's just stuff. Jesus' name, fear's got to go.
Fear's got to go. What's the last thing we say before we go?
Love God
and
love people.
All right, we'll see you next week. All right. Love God, love people. I like it. Let's go.